Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I wanted to talk to you today about some questions I've been getting regarding these little tiny carts that some do have some type of cooking apparatus and some don't. Some are kind of, they'll call it a hot dog cart and it's nothing but a box with wheels. And I'm not downplaying the value of those. What I want to tell you is what you would need, because twice in the last week I've gotten somebody that's bought this one from Lowe's. I didn't even know Lowe's sold a hot dog cart. But this cart is, it's not a cart. I guess it's classified as a cart, but it's not anything other than a box of metal, you know, hollow box metal thing with like bicycle wheels. And I'll show you a picture of that right here. And if you see that, you see that there's that in order to make that into something, okay, you're gonna need a steam table. And so this one person emailed me and said, Ben, I wanna, you know, put the steam table on top. Well, then he got to looking around, and steam tables on top for tabletop are not hard to find in electric. They're real hard to find in gas, but they're not impossible. You can find them in gas just with some Google searching, but they're outrageous expensive. Three times what a cart cost, or two times what a cart cost. So he messaged me back. He goes, what do I do? What do I need to do? I said, you need to buy a drop-in unit or build your own steam table. It's easy to build a steam table. Okay. And you can learn that at buildacart.com. You could take that one section, build a steam table, and you'd save hundreds of dollars over buying a commercial drop-in steam table. But a drop-in steam table is cheaper than a tabletop steam table, which he was trying to go with. So I told him, I said, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to frame it. You're going to have to go peel off the outside of that cart and frame it in so that it can handle the weight of a drop-in. Where the alternative is build your own steam table in it. And you could have a plumber do that, or a handyman, if you don't have the tools or the know-how or the will or desire to do it yourself. Then you'd still frame it up, but it wouldn't need to be weight supporting because it's not that heavy if you build it yourself. These commercial ones, they build super heavy. It doesn't add any value to it being heavy. It's just the way it is. The drop-ins are heavy, okay, because they have their own steel frame to support themselves, but they also have, you would have to add support slats and everything around it to hold it in the cart, and then you'd have to worry about your weight and balance. Because then what I told him, I said, you've also got your water, okay? And you look at, okay, let's say the state requires me to have 7 gallons of water on this cart. Well, 7 gallons, I think water weighs eight pounds a gallon, somewhere in there, 9 pounds a gallon. So you got 63 pounds on those little axles or little wheel bolts. And so you keep adding stuff, the framing, the drop-in, all the stuff. Pretty soon it can't handle what it's required to, or the weight and balance is off and makes it crazy wonky. And so you can bend the frame or whatever. But then there's this one, okay? And this one is more popular because they sell it on Amazon. And basically, it has a cutout for your steam table, but it uses little candles. So it's basically a little warmer. So you put these candles under it and drop your pan in. It's not for cooking, it's not for boiling, it won't even get to the temp that any state requires. So it makes it a lot harder. Now, I've had some people use it as a side item. So they'll have a boiler going and they'll dump boiled hot dogs and the hot water into one of these little ones. And now you could serve it safely for a little while, and then you'd have to reheat it up if you didn't run through that batch. So it causes a little bit of problems. It's not undoable though. I like the fact that people are thinking outside the box and going, okay, I want to start on a way, way lower budget. Well, the truth is if you look around, you can find used carts. Sometimes if you're patient, you will find incredible deals. $500 and you got a whole cart ready to go. And maybe a little cleanup or something. Then there's alternatives like setting it up without a cart, okay? And I show that over at learnhotdogs.com/broke. And it shows you how to start this business on a shoestring budget, whether it's side items on tables, or even you could build a cart. So you can go to buildacart.com and I show you the cart that you can build. So if you're handy at all, we walk you through the process of building an entire cart for less than $900. And it's still being done today. People are doing it. I have never had a year in over 10 years now where more people have built their own cart than this year. This year it's been incredible with the amount of people that have built their own cart. And the cool thing is you can customize it. You can do whatever you want to make it your own. We base it off our cash cow cart. So I wanted you to keep those things in mind when you're going, man, I can get this for $600. Now I got a hot dog cart from Lowe's. No, you got a red box with wheels. And you're going to have a trailer it. Not the end of the world, but you keep adding the things you're going to add. And pretty soon you're $4,000 or $5,000 into this. And you go, well, dang, I could have just bought a hot dog cart for $3,000. And so I want you to keep something else in mind. There's very few things that I know of that in business that you can do for a very small, reasonably, in comparison to, for a very small investment. Where this is a small investment, let's say you started a hot dog cart and you got a real nice big dog from me, and then you got your licensing and everything, you'd still be under $5,000. You'd be under $5,000, and you'd have your supplies, you'd have your food, you'd have your cart, you'd have everything. And with a potential of making 60, 80, 100, 150 your first freaking year, especially this year. COVID has made vendors go through the roof with business. And so it's mind-boggling to me how people will look at stuff on a cap rate. I don't know if you or heard of a cap rate, but a cap rate is how quickly does my money capitalize. And so they call it a cap rate. Let me give you an example. If you put in $100,000 on something and you get back 10% a year in profit, okay, it would take you 10 years to break even, right? But they call that a 10% cap rate. Okay, so $10,000 a year in profit on a $100,000 investment is a 10% cap rate. They usually only use that term cap rate in real estate, but it applies to anything. So that means your capitalization rate on your money is 10%. Well, that's freaking good in real estate. It's not good in entrepreneurial world. So in our world, that would be horrible. Most vendors are coming out the door, if they've done their due diligence, even they didn't buy nothing from me, just go through my free training. They come out the door and 60 days later, they're in the clear. We've got people that in 2 weeks have already paid, their business has already paid for the cart, just what they spent getting started. So you have to think about what those things, what's the value of those things and if it's right for you. So I'm not trying to push you towards, you know, oh, you need to buy a cart from me and save yourself the time. But because I want people to first search a used cart, first consider building your own. So the lower investment. But what if you're in a hurry? You don't want to build your own and take you a week and a half, 2 weeks, and you go, okay, I want to start now. Great. Buy a cart. Buy a used cart. And get going. And usually, well, like when I first started, I'm in a little tiny town. And I'm vending. I found out after the fact, just because I'm an idiot and didn't know about due diligence or anything, and I found out my city wasn't going to let me vend in the city limits. So I was vending outside of a tire store, and within seven weeks of vending, I was at 3 carts I had bought. I had paid my mother-in-law back for the first cart, and because she loaned us some money to help us get it, and then that first cart's profit made me enough money to buy 2 more carts. So I had 3 carts within 7 weeks. And I kept growing it. But the point is I've never seen a business where you can invest so little to make so much and quickly. So there's not a long term, I'm building this McDonald's, it's $3 million. And we expect in 22 years, we're gonna be profitable. What? I don't have 22 years. I didn't then for sure, and I don't now at all. And so you wanna do it. You want the safest, quickest, lowest risk investment to make the most money. So if you like the food industry, then obviously this makes sense, because vendors are doing catering with their carts. They're doing these private gigs where they're showing up at the hospital because the hospital is under the COVID restrictions. The cafeteria is not open anymore. And so we've got vendors outside hospitals all over America. A lot of opportunities, a lot of things you can do. I love you. If you have any questions, post them in the comments. Do me a favor. I don't run ads on my thing. I'm a YouTube partner, but I don't run ads. I hate ads when I'm trying to learn something or entertain myself with some YouTube something. And so hit the thumbs up. Give me a like. I'd appreciate it. And the comments, I appreciate them. I do answer them all. Sometimes I'm a few days behind. But as of today, I'm caught up. Anyway, I love you. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.